Okay, we're recording. We pick up with inverses and one-to-one functions, and all we're going to do is these four problems, and then we're done. Does Casey Gilbertson remember how do we test to see if a function is one-to-one? Horizontal line test and vertical line test. Very good. How do you find, boys and girls, how do you find the inverse of a function? How do you find the inverse? What values do you switch? X and Y, and then you solve for Y, and that will give you the inverse. How do you test to see if they are actually inverses of each other? Remember the composition? That's what we talked about yesterday. And that's what you have to be able to do. We are going to compose the two functions together. And if we come out with x in the end, we know that they are inverses. So that's what I'm going to do. So my first function says use the property of inverses to determine if f and g are inverses of each other. So the question is, are these inverses? Well, what I have to do is I have to take g. I'm gonna go like this. I'm gonna go f composed of g of x and see what I get. And if I do f composed of g of x, then I take g of x, and what do I do with it? I plug it into x right here, and my new function will read 3 times x plus 5 divided by 3 minus 5. Now, on tests, a lot of people just write x down because they know the answer should be x. No. It doesn't work like that. You have to show the whole problem through. And this is easy algebra. You guys know how to do it. I got x plus 5 minus 5 is x. That is not enough. I must also check the other way. So now I'm going to do g composed of f of x, and I should get x as well. So I take 3x minus 5, and I plug it in for x. If I do that, I get 3x minus 5 plus 5 divided by 3. Yeah? 5's cancel. So I got x for both of them. So this is where a lot of people get messed up too. They say, so is the answer x? No, the answer is not x. The answer is determine if they're inverses of each other. So what's the answer? Yes, they are inverses. I suppose another way you could write it is you could say g of x is equal to the inverse of f of x. That would be another way of saying the same thing. Questions? Can you do that? Let's try one that's a little bit more difficult. Let's try the next one. What do you want? Do you want to compose f of g or g of f first? F of g. Let's do f of g. That's my composition. I will take g of x, and I'll put it in right here. That's where you have to be careful. Let's see. We have 1 over x minus 2 plus 2, right? What happens there? 2's canceled. Get 1 over 1 over x. What's 1 over 1 over x? Multiply by the reciprocal. X. So we decide to switch. take this. Let's get into there. That will be g of f of x. I took f of x and plugged it in for g. 1 over 1 over x plus 2 minus 2. How do you simplify 1 over 1 over x plus 2? Multiply by the reciprocal and you get x plus 2 minus 2 is x. Billy, need to see that worked out? No? Savvy? How many girls chew on your hair? You ever chew on your hair? Well, I'm just wondering. My daughter, you know, she's 7 years old. When you're little, you do? I have a different daughter. I have a 7-year-old daughter named Kiara, thank you very much, Cody, and she could dunk all over you. Skywalker, yeah. You don't take responsibility for your own actions. Skywalker, you wouldn't talk trash about my family, would you? You might. Ooh. Maybe you like to take me on a little one-on-one. All right. I'll bring my shoes tomorrow. Get ready to break an ankle. That's Tenley, yeah. Kira's 7. Yeah. You know, she's like, you know, she'll be reading and she'll quick stick her hair in her mouth. Maybe she's just flossing. Yeah, it's like, you know, save money, right? I have a very proud moment of Kira. I'll tell you after we do these two problems. This was a big deal in our family. So f of x equals 4x squared for x greater than or equal to 0, and g of x is x squared of x over 2. I'm going to look at that later on, guys. I'm going to look at that later on. First, I'm just going to go through the motions here. So we'll do f composed of g of x. So I'm going to take g of x. And when I plug that in, I get 4 times square root of x over 2 quantity squared. What do you get when you square the square root of x over 2? X over 4. So you get 4 times x over 4, which is simply x. Okay, we're going to do the other way around. We'll take 4x squared and we'll plug it in for there now. So that's going to be g composed of f of x. So I plug f of x in for g and I get the square root of 4x squared. Over 2. What's the square root of 4x squared? 2x over 2, which is x. And now you're wondering, what does this x greater than or equal to 0 mean? That's really important, you guys. And we do need to understand exactly what that means. If I draw this graph, and I draw 4x squared, what does 4x squared look like? Parabola, upside, or up or down? Up, okay. So as I graph this parabola, go up, that's 4x squared. What does the square root of x over 2 look like? Yeah, very good. Andy sees it. Goes like this. And graphically, we know that functions are inverses of each other if they're flipped over the line y equals x. So if I draw the line y equals x, you can tell that, for the most part, it's there. But I'm going to suggest to you guys that if I take the blue function and I flip it over the line y equals x, I'm not going to get the red. I'm going to get the red plus this. Would you agree? What's wrong with this? It's not a function. It doesn't pass a vertical line test. So you can see when you have a function that is not one-to-one, is this parabola one-to-one? It's not one-to-one because it doesn't pass the horizontal line test. Therefore, you have to restrict the domain for when you find its inverse. So the problem did that. It said, I'm only talking about x values greater than or equal to 0. So should we even graph this part? No. So if we take that part off, and you just look at the blue part, if I flip the blue part over the line y equals x, I'll get just that red part. So that's why they restrict the domain. If you have a function that is not one-to-one, you have to restrict the domain for when you find the inverse. Otherwise, the inverse will not be a function. That's all there is to it. Got it? Oh, for x greater or equal to 0, so you would say, from 0 to infinity is the domain? Yeah, that'll be fine. So square root of x over 2 is the inverse of 4x squared for values 0 to infinity. Okay, so the domain has been restricted. We're fine. Good. Okay, last problem. Is it possible to have two functions that are identical and they are inverses of one another? Do you think that these two will be inverses? Let's try it. F composed of g of x. I take g of x, which is 1 over x to the third, and I plug it in for x right there. I get 1 over x to the third power. So that means I have 1 on top. What is 1 to the third power? 1. And what is x to the third power? X to the ninth. And 1 over x to the ninth is x to the ninth. Is that okay? No. No, they are not inverses. Here's two examples where functions are inverses of each other. If you have f of x is equal to x, and g of x equal to x, those are inverses of each other. Here's another one. F of x equals 1 over x, g of x equals 1 over x. Those work. In fact, I think that we could even do, say, f of x equals the square root of 9 minus x squared, and g of x equals the square root of 9 minus x squared. I think that those work as well. So there's a lot of examples where you can have two that are identical, and they are inverses of one another. But it doesn't always work like that. Okay? Any questions? So today we just practiced finding those inverses. You guys have, almost a half an hour. I've extended your assignment a little bit. Section 2.9, page 236, problems 22 through 25 and 28 through 30 are exactly like what we have done. In problems 61 and 62, you will be restricting the domain like we talked about yesterday and just a little bit today. If you can't get 61 or 62 on your own, it's okay. We can talk about those tomorrow. So I will have your study guide ready for you by tomorrow, no questions asked. In fact, I might, if you guys let me make copies, I might be able to even do it during class today. Can I tell you my quick story? Okay, I'll tell you about Kira. Let me turn YouTube off.